I was fortunate to be asked to help take Boomer and Sooner to Atlanta, Georgia for the Peach Bowl. I knew it was going to be a long trip, but I had no idea what I was in for. I didn't realize that the Sooner Schooner was such a celebrity, not only for college football, but for the United States. Growing up in Oklahoma, I just thought that the Sooner Schooner was part of OU. I didn't quite realize just how big this was. I don't know if it's the two ponies, or the thought, or the symbol of that can-do attitude. Please remember that I shot this with my cell phone, so some of the video is going to be grainy and the audio might be a little rough, but I think y'all are going to enjoy. I know it's early in the morning, sweetie. Put some new ones on you when we get there. Midnight morning snack.
3 a.m.
When we started loading the horses in the trailer, their realization that I was going to be hauling such precious cargo really made me nervous, to be honest. But my good friend Todd believed in me that I was able to drive a rig that is roughly the same length as a semi. I had been to many OU games at home and away, but never like this. Never where the access that I was going to be granted, where I could be on the field, behind the scenes, up and close and personal to everything.
Oh yeah. That's cool.
So what's your name?
Alex Tyner.
Alex, where are you from?
I'm from Tulsa.
Oh, I'm from Tulsa? Excellent.
Yeah.
Boomer Sooner.
Boomer Sooner.
Boomer Sooner.
Watching the game, right?
You better
cheer the boys
it.
On.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's like 4 o'clock in the morning. We're on Interstate 40. We just went and filled up. So, back on the road.
Boomer Sooner!
Well, we've stopped for a little bit. Check on our little ponies. See how we're doing in here. Hey, sweetie, how are you? So they have covers on their eyes because we're going to have the windows open so they can get some fresh air. Hi, sweetheart. How are you? This is Boomer. We'll come over here. This is Sooner. Hey, baby. Hey, sweetie. How are you? How's the driving? You doing all right? Eating a little grass. Checking their water bowl. We'll go around to the back here. Sun is starting to come up now. peek in here. Get a little treat. There you go. Guys are all washed. Look how soft their fur is.
Little did I know, this is where Todd tossed me the keys and told me that it was my turn to drive. So, for the next 8 hours, I drove. Located about 20 minutes north of downtown Atlanta is this equestrian center that we were able to keep the horses at. The people at this center were just amazing people. When we arrived, they had already prepped the stalls with the shavings, with water, and were actually waiting on us to arrive and helped us bring the horses in, and the food and the grain, and made it seamless. As you can see here, the facilities were top notch.
He's like, I want some food! Oh, home sweet home hungry, here, huh?
So hungry. So hungry.
What do you think about that, huh? You like your new hotel room? Like your new hotel room? Good morning. Hey, sweetie. Hey, sweetie. Hi, baby. How are you? Did you get a good night's sleep? Hi, sweetie. Good morning, Boomer.
Your monster.
Well, we made it to Atlanta. It is early in the morning. We're getting ready to go to the walkthrough. And so Boomer and Sooner are here. We got some blankets on them this morning because it's a little bit chilly. They're getting some breakfast. They did really well. Got a good night's sleep. And so now we're gonna make our way down. Thank you, buddy, sorry. Down to the stadium and everything. I'll show you a little bit of the trailer. So inside here, there's all the stuff that they wear is right here. And then Boomer and Sooner, they ride here in their own slots or their stalls. And then in the back, you can see, is the schooner. Take the top off of it, put it back there, ratchet it down like a race car. So in here, so they have their feed, and they have their hay, which hooks up right here. So they have a nice little bag of hay to chew on. All right,
each one of these stalls then slides in, locks in so they ride, not sideways, but kind of at a 45 degree angle so that they can adjust for any bounce in the road. What do you think, sweetie? We are here at Mercedes-Benz Stadium. It is amazing. It is unbelievable. We're underneath in the catacombs. The schooner has arrived. We're going to get ready to pull in. They're getting ready to launch to open the gate. All right, here we go. It's gonna be tight over here. You're gonna have to come around and get over on the other side of that big tray, of the big OU one. And I would film, but I gotta get up here and make sure that we don't hit anything.
One of the biggest reasons to come to the stadium a day before, besides the run through, is to let the ponies get used to a new environment, especially a stadium of this size and magnitude, which will be really, really loud the next day. So as you can see here, we'll start prepping the horses. They have a felt collar that's padded, and then the round ring that you see that goes around the head is what part of the harness attaches to, so that it pulls on the chest or the front of the horse versus in one spot. Everywhere we go, the horses get brushed and cleaned. That's why they look so pretty and healthy.
So, this is how the Oklahoma football team travels. This is their track. I'll give you a little glimpse of it here. We made it.
We
did.
Oh, we did.
We're going to kick some ass.
Absolutely.
Kicking some ass.
I wish I could give you a scope of the size of the stadium. It's fascinating. It's like nothing I have ever seen. There's not a roundness to it. It's more angled off, which is... It's really impressive. I'm going to turn around here and show you the dome of it, because it actually opens and looks kind of like an iris of a camera. Of course, it'll be closed today because it's cold outside. Well, let's take a look here. This place is going to be rocking.
This was the first time that I walked out onto the field, and for some reason it hit me that I was there, standing on this field, and something came over me, and I almost started crying. You can see in this next clip here that I have to stop it because my eyes are starting to tear up. For the next 20 or 30 minutes, Todd and his wife, Tanya, walked Boomer and Sooner up and down the sidelines so they could get used to the environment and the sounds, especially with the band there. We wanted to make sure that they were comfortable, that it wasn't going to be a new experience. I decided to stay and watch a little bit of the band practice. It was neat to see them practicing and how all of it took place.
Okay, here's the what we came for. We're gonna practice the running of the schooner down the field. My job is to be down here to guide and hopefully not have to catch them, but if things go wrong, then it's my job to make sure and see if we can keep this accidents from happening. So. Alright, so this is going to be the parade route.
Channel 2
is
over there.
Well, that's good.
We gotta be on Channel 2.
I'll do a little spin here.
Channel 2.
We'll go out here in the street so you guys can see what it looks like before everything gets going. Atlanta's finest will take care of all this here. So yours truly has been picked to drive the truck to follow Sooner Schooner. So I guess I'm driving in the parade today. This ought to be interesting. Well, the band's here. Let me show you that. Everybody's starting to show up now. Around this side. Schooner's getting ready. Ponies together. So these are the stickers that we put on their hooves so that they look good going down the stream. Alright, so let's continue. I'm here with the big guy. Joe, you want to say hi to everybody?
Good morning, Boomer Sooner. And we're ready for game.
Absolutely.
Sit up and talk. They want to go on making crazy.
Myself, the electricity down here is just amazing. The echo off the buildings is so cool. Well, we made it through the parade, no problems, and next time you probably see me, we'll be inside there. So we're going to enjoy, take a little downtime for a moment, and regroup, probably get the ponies in, let them get a drink of water, eat some lunch, and we'll go from there.
So over the next 3 hours, it was probably close to 10 to 15,000 people that came by. There were a few that took pictures with the actual schooner, but the overwhelming majority of people wanted to have their picture taken with those two little horses. The other thing that was amazing, that it wasn't just OU fans and LSU fans. We had fans from, there were Alabama fans and Tennessee fans. I think there was a Michigan fan. They were just, I didn't realize that it was the schooner, but also this rig, this truck, and this trailer. It was amazing to be driving down the interstate and people just honking and waving and slowing down and filming as they went by. So what happens next is that we can't get back to the stadium. So what do? We decide to go with the football players. We just acted like it was all part of the plan. We spoke with the Georgia State Troopers, and they had no problem with us falling in behind the bus.
Hey, sweetheart, I'm sorry that you couldn't make it, but I brought a few friends here to tell you that they love you. So, one, two, three.
What came next was the realization that we were going to have to move all these people out of the way in order for us to get actually in behind the football players. And so it became quite chaotic.
Go! Go! We got him! Got him! Got him! our turn here. Let's see if we make sure we have any problems. Okay, I don't know if you guys just caught all of that, that craziness that just happened, but we made it through. We're here, we're underground, we're at the safety check here. And my boys, everybody say hi.
What is still fascinating to me is that the people that work at the stadium, the police officers, the special agents, everybody had their cameras out to take pictures of these two horses.
Come on, Jalen, let's go, bud. You got it, bro.
I decided not to film any of the actual football game. Since it was going to be on national television, there was no need for me to document that.
I see your dirty face, hide behind your collar, but it's done in vain. Truth is hard to swallow, so you pray to God to justify the way you live a lie, live a lie, live a lie. And you take your time, and you do your crime. Well, you made your bed, I made mine. Because when I arrive, I bring the fire, make you come alive. I can take you higher, what this is for God. I must now remind you, let it rock, let it rock, let it rock. Now the son's disgraced, he who knew his father when he cursed his name, turned and chased the dollar, but it broke.
Well, the game didn't go as planned. So wasn't the highlight of the trip, but anyway, here we are the next morning getting ready to go get our ponies and head it home. Looks like it's supposed to rain today on the way home, so I imagine we will slowly make our way. Thank you.
We made it home. It's right after midnight on Monday morning, and we made it. It's been quite a ride. Had some ridiculous rain in Memphis, and but it's been just amazing. Even driving back, it is the people honking and waving and taking pictures. It's just been a trip of a lifetime for me. So anyway, it's time to get the ponies out and put them in bed. Oh, time to put the little girls to bed. It's nice and cold outside. Oh, goodness gracious. Hold on, baby. Hi, guys, we're home. We're home. Hello. And there's the puppies. There's the puppies. Hello.
I was so fortunate to be able to spend so much time with Todd and his wife and their two kids. It was neat to see a family unit so tight. We were able to go to dinner, have breakfast, do all these things together in such tight windows. And we had an absolute blast. We laughed so hard that my face actually hurt when I woke up in the morning.
Got a stock. Oh my god.
That hurt.
Oh my god, dude. That is. Oh!
Oh! This is two grown men that haven't progressed past the age of 12.
Oh.